Sejin here. So I'm going to show you how you can create amazing worlds using a text prompt and then transform it into a 360-degree video for YouTube or for any of your favorite social media platforms. Whether you want to create soothing meditation videos for monetization, or create super cool background animation for your next YouTube project, or maybe create YouTube shorts and add a storytelling avatar.
But the universe had set in motion a series of extraordinary events that would change his life forever.
Your creativity is your only limit. I'll take you through it step by step, so make sure you watch until the very end. If you like this sort of content, make sure you subscribe to this channel. Let's dive right in. Go to blockadelabs.com. Click sign up to get started. I'll log in with my Google account. This beautiful open space is called a skybox, and this is where you generate your world using the prompt bar below. The prompt bar is pretty straightforward. Let's jump right in and start generating. But before I do, there's some things I don't want appearing in my skybox, so I'll input the words into the negative text box. Blurry people person. Enhanced prompt basically enhances your text prompt with extra filler words to make your world more detailed and unique. Here you have literally 48 different render styles to choose from, so you'll never go bored generating your worlds. If you're on the free version, then you'll be limited in the number of styles to choose from. These styles look pretty cool in my opinion. I mean, if you kind of think about all the different possible worlds you can generate using these different styles, doesn't it make you want to jump in and start generating right away? Now, when generating prompts, it's recommended that you keep it simple to about 3 to 4 text phrases. Let's do something real simple. A medieval castle surrounded by a lush forest, waterfall with a hidden cave. Let me choose the fantasy render style and hit generate. It literally takes less than a minute to generate your world. Oh, just the style I like. It kind of looks like an ancient ruin from the Tomb Raider game. The texture is beautiful and the lighting is perfect. I can remix the skybox by clicking the remix this option to render different styles using the same prompt. Here are some sample remixes. Realism, digital painting, manga, storybook, surreal, kid CGI animation, low poly triangles, watercolor, pen and ink. Now here's the fun part. If you go over to the toolbar, you can draw on the elements you want to generate. If you click on the brush tool, you can adjust the brush size here. You have your eraser tool. Your editing options are here, and the different types of guides such as sphere grid, cube grid, skybox view, and plane view. Let me draw in a couple of 3D looking buildings. You can click on the hand icon or hold down the space bar to move around. Let me draw some trees. The lines are kind of thick, but it's okay. Oh, and I can't forget about the main road. Yeah, I'm not very good at this, but if you're anything like me, you don't have to worry about making your drawing perfect since the skybox AI will perfect it for you. Well, sort of. Okay, this doesn't look too bad. Now let's generate the drawing with a prompt text. Futuristic cityscape in the morning, lush greenery and forest. Let's select the realism style. Oh, this came out really nice. These definitely look like futuristic skyscrapers. Plenty of greenery everywhere, and I guess the forest is on the bottom. You can see your drawing outline all around the skybox. Yeah, I'm pretty pleased with the results. Now remember, all your generated worlds are saved in my dashboard. If you like what you see, you can download it. You have many different formats you can choose from, but for this tutorial, we'll download it as a landscape video. For YouTube Shorts and TikTok, you can download the portrait video. If you have the free version, you can download it as an image, which you can also create into a video, which I'll show you in the next step. Now it's time to create the video. You'll need the CapCut video editor, which you can download the desktop version or use the web version on capcut.com, or you can find it on the App Store or Play Store. I personally prefer the desktop version. Click New Project, import your video or videos, and drag it onto the timeline. If you think the video is too fast, you can click speed and reduce the time to slow down the speed, or you can simply increase the video duration. If you want the video to constantly rotate, just make a copy of the video by holding down the Alt, then click and drag the video on top. Or you can click on the video and copy and paste the video on top. Drag the video into place, or you can add another video to change the scene. Okay, looks pretty good. Now you can add some music and sound effects for 100% free on CapCut. Click on audio and search for the type of music. I'll search for meditation music. I'll use this one and let me drag it on the timeline. Let's add some bird sounds. Click on sound effects and search for birds. Drag it onto the timeline. Okay, that sounds really good. Now let's export it. Click export, type in a title, make sure the resolution is at 4K, and hit export, and you're done. But what do I do if I have an image? Import your image and drag it onto the timeline. You'll want to scale the image as big as possible to hide any type of watermark. And then make sure the left side of the image is aligned with the left frame box. You can adjust the speed of the video by changing the size of the image. The longer the image size, the slower the video speed. Make sure to set back the playhead to the beginning and click add keyframe for position. Now set the playhead to the end of the image, then drag the image on the player and move it to the end and align it to the right side of the play frame. The keyframe should be selected automatically. Click play. This looks pretty good. You can do the same thing and add music and sound effects to create your final product. And click the export button. So how do I create an avatar? Then make sure to watch this video.